Hey guys, so today we're working on a 2012 Dodge Ram and we're going to be installing a Hiniker plow and hitch. So we're going to get started with this install with the wiring. So before you get started, it's a really good idea to familiarize yourself with the owner's manual and look at all the wiring schematics as well. To make life easier, we're going to remove the front grille to get more room to run the wires, and we're going to remove the headlight housings as well to wire up our headlights and our turn signals. So I'll show you where I'm at right now. So I've gone ahead and laid the wire out. So we zap strap these relays over here. We have this little T connection here. So one end over here is for your headlights. Now what I did was, this is why we want to take off the grill. We ran down here for the wiring. And you can see it comes up underneath here. So we ran actually with the factory stuff. So here's the factory wiring right here. And then here's the Hiniker harness. We're gonna zap strap that all together nice and clean. And then here's the other set of lights over here. And then for the plow, we have this connection down here coming out through the bumper. Next, we have to run the wiring inside the cab. Because this vehicle is an automatic, we have the access point here where the clutch would usually go on your master. So I've gone ahead and made a hole for it, and then we can pass all the wire through that hole. So originally, the way the wiring is laid out in the harness, your solenoid would typically go somewhere in this general vicinity of the vehicle. We didn't really like that because it was going to be exposed to a lot of the elements. So what we've gone ahead and done was we extended the wires that activate the solenoid, and we're going to go and run it along the driver's side and hook up the solenoid on the driver's side firewall. To get to that side, we're going to run through this factory loom right here. So here's the part that we modified, mainly putting the solenoid back here so it's away from the elements. We tap and dyed this firewall and then put all stainless hardware in, so it's nice. And everything's all zap strapped and tightened away. Now before you bun up this hole, you probably want to go ahead and put some strip chalk on that or some sort of silicone to seal up this hole again going through the firewall. So in order for safety, there is a wire on this harness that will only allow you to use the plow when the ignition's on. On this truck, you could hit the ignition, but a lot of it's CAN bus, so to make it easy for you guys, on these trucks you have two cigarette outlets or power outlets. Now you can see that I got the piece out, so you can see that there was a 7mm bolt up here. You have to remove this bottom panel up here. This pulls straight forward, it's just clipped in. There's another 7mm down below it. So now we have the wires exposed and we're ready to test them. So we got my power probe hooked up to one of the wires that I want to test. Right now it's showing ground, and we're going to cycle the ignition now and see what it switches over to. So it switches over to 12 volts positive or hot, and that's the wire that we want to hook up into. So I've gone ahead and soldered the connection. I am not using any of the T-taps provided in the kit. You can use the T-taps, that's fine. I just prefer to solder and tape all my connections. So I'm just going to go ahead and tape this up, and we're going to button up the dash again. So if you have difficulty taking out the headlights, I'm going to show you the parts we have to tackle. So on the housing, you have a 10mm here. Then you have another 10mm down here, going down vertical. You do not have to remove the grill, but like I said before, if you have more room, you can run everything a lot nicer. And then, there's an access panel, an inner fender well. Pop that open. So what you're gonna be looking for is this guy right here. So, it'll be in the down position, locking the housing in, and then when you push it up, that'll unlock it. Now the housing, if this is a brand new truck like this one, it's gonna be loose, and then you're gonna think there's another 10mm or something in holding it in because it's really tight. What it actually is this ball right here goes into this right here. It's pretty tight, so you have to yank on it pretty good to get the housing out. Once you got it out, then you can start wiring up your lights. Okay, so next we're gonna do the lights. We have a piggyback system right here. So you can see we have these two plugs on one end, and this one here. So remember those lights or those wires that I ran towards the front? I have it over here now. So we're gonna plug it in on the 5-pin. And you wanna press it in good, because it's a weather sealed connection. Now to take out your headlight, there's a little red piece here of plastic that locks it. Pull that out with a screwdriver. Push this down with your thumb and pull it out. Now on the other two, you'll see how it piggybacks now. This black end now goes into the original harness. We can lock that in. And then we take this plug, which is like the original one, and it'll go back on to the stock plug. And then we can wire up our parking lights and everything afterwards, and our signals. So I've taken the plug out to figure out my marker lights or my parking lights, and I've gone ahead and tested all three wires. And the middle one here, this white with a green stripe, gives me 12 volt positive when the switch is turned on. So we're gonna go ahead and solder that on. So now we're going to test for signal on the driver's side. So we're going to pick this prong on this side right here. So it is just the white wire on this side that I need to hook up into for my left turn signal. Once you've made all your connections, you got all your wires tucked away, you can go ahead and button it up. And don't forget to close the access panel and the inner fender well. We're installing the Hiniker hitch now. We have to put these brackets in. We have to hammer these on over the sway bar. So you have to drop the sway bar, then put the bracket in, and then the sway bar goes back on over the top of these brackets. And here you can see the kit comes with a shim. That shim goes right above the sway bar bushing. You must install that if you want to make sure the truck maintains a factory ride. Next, we gotta pull up the factory air dam. So on the first bit, we gotta remove these plastic push pins. Remove the center part first. Pull that out. I think you can probably pry out the inner one. There's also three push pins on each side, just like the center of the bumper. And on the sides, you have a machine bolt, and when you pull that bolt out, it'll drop right out after. To make room for the brackets, we're gonna zip this part off on the splash shield. So what we're doing here is we're tightening everything from the lowest part to the highest part. So we're doing the hitch first, and we do the brackets last, just so we have it all nice and all goes into place. So the Hiniker kit comes with this bracket, and you can place it somewhere in the bumper, allowing you to zap strap it or make your own bracket. I would put it back here, but for now, for testing purposes, we're gonna leave the wiring loose for now.